So let's take a look at the overview of the reactions for this lab. The whole goal is to find out how much sodium bicarbonate baking soda there is. And we're going to use stoichiometry to do that. In this overview, all our numbers are going to be in millimoles. So let's just say you measure out 15 millimoles. And remember, that's excess HCl. So we're going to consume all the baking soda. And we've added 15 millimoles of HCl. So when we do that, the next step is to figure out how much excess HCl. And so we're going to titrate using sodium hydroxide. So let's say that when you add 4 millimoles, you lose that red color. Okay, so you know you added 15 millimoles. We consume the excess. We still don't really know how much there is, but it took 4 moles to consume the excess HCl. Now, because this reaction is a one-to-one reaction, we know there must have been 4 millimoles of excess HCl. So if we scroll down a bit, let me get this number. We know we had 15 millimoles to start with. Our excess is HCl, 4 millimoles of excess HCl. So that must have mean we needed 11 millimoles. So I'm going to back up to this equation up top here. Our total amount was 15, but I'm going to take that out for a second and say we actually only needed 11 millimoles of HCl for this to be perfect one-to-one reaction. And again, because of the balanced chemical equation, this is a one-to-one relationship, we know then that there is must have been 11 millimoles of baking soda. So that's a good overview of the type of math we're doing, keeping it in terms of millimoles. It's very similar to the math we've been doing with tires and bike frames, and millimoles is a good way to keep it. Where it gets tricky is we get grams of baking soda and sodium hydroxide. For every gram is 0.5 millimoles, so we'll help with that. But sometimes it's good just to look at the big picture.